Almost all the tournaments by the grace of God, but I think it's a love and support of you guys because of which we are here. Thank you.
Well, and let me just conclude this conversation saying that especially doing this for the players as well as the back-end team of Sportino that is handling, doing this in the park month of Ramadan, I think it's very special. You guys all do Roza every day, and you wait for the Sehri. It's an auspicious month, I would say, for all of us. And I think to end it, I think that Almighty is taking care of all you lovely guys out here.
Definitely, yes, Deepesh, kind words. What's more important is this man, he looks very young, but he's too old, which I personally...
He's my rescue man, by the way. He's my rescue man. Like, whenever I want a break, I was like, Kasim, where are you? Like, come here, like, just be a good support to me, but he's been excellent.
He's a rescue man, not just for you. He's a rescue man for everybody, for being the technical team, being for me, being for you, being for any teams. Being for any team, being for any owners, any players need any help, wants to register, wants to play, wants anything, call this guy 9820334011. 24 hours available with a headache.
Well, since Kasim is here, right from sticking the tape with your team to managing the entire show with your team, of course, because it's not one person who is putting it up, but it's the entire team show eventually reflecting a good name that is coming forward for Sportino. I know it's an emotional moment for you. Quick thoughts on it before we start the quarterfinal number one.
Slowly, you know, we've started off with only two of us. Now the team is growing. So slowly, we are getting.
Okay, add me into this.
So we've got eight members now. We were two, we have seven now. You're the eighth member. And thank you to Deepesh. You know, we're also learning a lot from him. The commentary part, he's excellent at his job. We keep liking his post. We keep following him all the time, to learn a lot from him.
Thank you so much.
What's more important, I would like to add the dedication. That's most important. Passion is something where you do. Passion is there. Yes, there is passion for commentary. Or there is passion for cricket. Agreed. But there's something called dedication. People who don't know this, his mother was unwell. His mother was in the hospital. She had a minor attack. But this man was here on the ground doing commentary. He was always on time and he's never asked to go early or come late. So,
passion, spirit of cricket, passion, determination.
I think just one thing to add, when my mom got that minor attack and I asked her that, should I go today? And she always said that the show must go on, don't wait up for me.
Absolutely. So, we wish you a speedy recovery. And Deepesh, you are a dedicated man. Thank you so much for the kind words.
Thank you so much, guys.
And quarterfinals one, on your way.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Hello. Check. Azun Trovado, Thoda. Hello. Check. Hello. Check. Hello. Alright, welcome to Ibja Gold Presents Mumbai Cricket Stars Season 8, powered by Looming Liquids and supported by B. Kandari Properties and Nitton. You can see the two Super 8 boards out here. On the left, you see a Nitton Super 8, and on the right, you see a B. Kandari Properties Super 8. So, this is all the fun of the game, and because first over is designed in such a way that the D category players come out. The one down also is a D category. Just repeating it because it's the way the design of this game I would just like to explain. Well, when you have this, it's also a D category bowler bowling at you. If you get out in this first over, it's a minus five. Then we wait for second and third over, but not for second and third over much, but we wait for the fourth over, which is the monster over brought to you by B. Kandari Properties and Nitton. And after that, the four overs later on, after the fourth over, is always pretty exciting. Today, it's an important game for each and everyone out here because it's a do and die situation. It's a knockout stage that we all are a part of it. And we are entering into a very special one. Are you ready with all the creatives?
We are definitely. From day one, we are ready. Till the last day, we are going to be ready. We are rocking.
I think the way you're sounding, you're just not ready for the quarterfinals, but ready for the semifinals, final, and the season 9 as well.
I am ready from the day one. and we all are ready. We go for it.
All right, then go for it, and we'll wait for the umpires, the main umpire PC Patil, who is standing there. We also have a very special umpire, Sashi Satam. Sashi?
Rupesh
Sawant, then we have Deepal, then we have Jitendra, then we have PC Patil sir, then we have Padmanap standing there, then we have Ajit Golatkar who is standing behind the stumps, and now we are all waiting for the word go. There is a go ahead from the main umpire PC Patil as Yash Babani rolls the ball, and the first one given utmost respect, and it's a dot ball. The live action has begun. The first quarterfinals, ladies and gentlemen. This is a direct hit, and Munawar is confident that he is inside. Well, that is the energies and that is the passion for the game that we are expecting tonight. Bhavik Joshi very quickly on the ball and trying to get a run out here, but Munawar was fast and he was inside the crease. So the very first over has started. Yash Babani as he rolls his wrist to spin that ball. It's Munawar now. And Munawar has been put into some kind of a pressure with the fielding. We have Dharmesh Fa with Arjun. And we have Nihal as well standing very close to the crease. Bit of an excitement here because Munawar is a player who wants to go from ball one. And so does he try. That is a wonderful shot, changing the strikes here. So Yash Babani starting on a good note. Five balls have been bowled, only two runs given. That's going to be a dead ball. No one was ready. That's a good strike into the gaps. Aditya completing the single, keeping the strike to himself. And it's the end of the first over. Very well by Yash Babani. And the first over ends in three for no loss. So over number two coming up here. So it's a keeper change also. Far comes behind the stumps. And that is a good strike into the gap and straight down the ground for the first boundary of this quarterfinals. Picking up the gap very well, Yash Babani could not do anything, and Bhavik Joshi could only be a spectator. Wonderful boundary coming up on the very first ball of Sanket Rathod. That's nicely tapped straight in the hands of Arjun. That one's in the air, and that will be a wonderful shot. We'll have to check, and the call is it's a boundary. No, it's a sixer given by the umpire. So the second over was very fruitful. One boundary, one sixer coming up. And this is one more. But this time it will just cling on to the extra mid-wicket region, and then it will land up into the boundary. So two boundaries, one sixer. So it's a good start by Smashers. Did not got too many runs on the first over, but I think they've managed to pick it up in the second over. The first over ended with three runs, but they've easily managed to gather more, 15 of just four deliveries that have been bowled. One more, what a shot, straight down the ground, and that is a beautiful sixer. Bundawa striking that ball middle of the bat, and there's no chance for the fielder there. He could only be a spectator in this power play over by Sanket Rathod. This one's in the air again, into the gap. There's quite a chase. Bhavik Joshi coming on the ball. Good throw there from the deep. Far will have to do a good cover up. So after the end of two overs, it is 25 runs, which are very well earned here. So Munawar here doing most of the hittings. That's a soft dismissal, but I think he's done his job very nicely. He's been a wonderful opener batsman for Smashers. Never ever upset his team, but done his job. And here comes a new batsman, Ankur Thakrani, here in the center. And just in the last match, when he was sitting here next to me as a 12th man, he was the score predictor. And trust me, he was accurate. All I can say, it comes all from experience. It comes all from studying the team on paper more and watching their games, watching their mistakes that they've done in the past. And that makes you kind of a predictor that who's going to play what basis the situation of the game. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is the understanding of cricket. But on the first ball, he goes without troubling the scorers. He's back in the pavilion, and it's quick two wickets. First to go was Munawar, who was playing some excellent shots out here. But then it is Ankur Thakrani, the owner of Smashers, going back to the pavilion, trying to hit an ambitious shot on the very first ball. And there comes Sharfu. Sharfu again is a challenging young lad who is on from the ball one. And what I like about him is he's fearless. He doesn't want to know who is the bowler bowling at me, because he's got equal talent to face that bowling. And I think he's been excellent in the field. You know, he always loves to field at the long on region. And I think we've seen some amazing saves on that long on position when it comes to fielding. But today, he's got a different role to play because you have some great bowling lineup coming up from Kandari Kings. You have Dharmesh Panchal, who is bowling now. There's Nihal, there's Shiraz, there's Arjun, of course. Yash has already bowled. Bhavik will soon see in the monster over. Sanket Rathod has already bowled a spell. So there is a depth in the bowling coming up as well. The call was from Sharfu, and he ensured that he made the ground pretty easily. A wonderful start here by both the teams. It's going to be an excruciating day of cricket because if this is the kind of action that we're seeing in the first three overs, the third over is not even ended. The third over is on. But if you're seeing so much of action, so much of drama in this very first innings of Kandari Kings and Smashers, then I think there is lots more to watch. And what is to watch are these kind of boundaries and sixers. Ibja Gold boundary, Ibja Gold sixer, everything coming out here in the center. And all those lovely audiences or the spectators who've just joined here, Ibja Gold welcomes you all to this wonderful Mumbai Cricket Stars Season 8, powered by Living Liquids and supported by B. Kandari Properties and Niton. Just one to go in that third over. We'll just love the footwork on that last ball. Coming on the front foot, charging onto the ball. Only a single to end that one, but Sharfu will keep the strike. So it's a big over coming up now, the monster over, brought to you by B. Kandari Properties and Niton. And of course, a very fine battery. So Bhavik Joshi coming out here. A quick single here and a bit of a misfielding there by the fielder.
Check.
And all that Smashers would be looking at not to put a wicket in this over. Nicely played. He has a chance of a run out. It's just that what kind of calls that we're taking. Fa was calling for the ball. And there was a possible run out. Sharfu was the important man here. That's a good striker, punching the ball straight to the fielder there.
Check. Check.
Oh. Again, nicely flicked that one, only for a single here.
Hello, check. Hello.
Bhavik not really happy with the way fielding is going on out here, because all that support the bowler needs is a quick fielding, a quick response on the outfield that just keeps the momentum of the bowling going on. 40 up for smashers. Nicely bowled straight in the hands of Farr. He makes no mistake, and that's a dot ball. A very important over, nicely bowled by Bhavik Joshi. A lot of experience backing him up. That is what makes the difference, and that's the reason he's out there for the monster over. That is a slower one and an intentional one straight in the hands of the keeper Preet there. Fatty up playing on the average of 10 runs per over for the loss of 2 wickets here. 40 at the end of 4 overs. So Nihal now comes out to bowl. Bit of a nice fielding arrangement here. You got a wideish mid-on just to cover that wider area. Yash on the mid-on. Bhavik on mid-off. But the ball straight lands up in the hands of Nihal. He drops this one. An important wicket that has gone down. Trying to hit across the line, Aditya. Please. Standing very close to the crease here. Dharamesh again very close. Shiraz on the long off region. Sanket at the long on. Pretty nice fielding arrangement here. Arjun at the point. That is a big one, and that is going to be an MCS out. One more wicket falling down. The opener batsman Adi tried to do something ambitious here, but failing to his own strategy. The shot was good, but the elevation even looked better. Not the execution was that great, and it's an MCS out. So another wicket falls down, the third wicket down, and we have an exclusive day of cricket here with 4 quarterfinals. The first one in front of you. Kandari Kings and Smashers. Here comes the run machine, as I call him, Habib Rahman. Comes to the striker's end. Habib has been a player to watch for, because he has the potential of taking the score to a new height, especially the way he hits the ball into the gaps. Very sensible batsman. Now it's an important game for him as well. Nihal picking up the wicket, and it's Habib Rahman now who's going to face it. The very first ball bowled outside the off stump, bringing towards the middle stump. Bit of a tricky situation for Habib. Or maybe on the ball he was just trying to check the line. Goes on the foot straight in the hands of Bhavik here. Dead ball. Sharfu was ready for it. That's again hit wider. straight in the hands of the fielder there. Only a single. But I think they're very going very nicely. They're shaping it up pretty well. Good over by Nihal, just giving two runs till now. Because at the end of the monster over, it was 40. Picking up a wicket as well in this over. A very important one of Aditya Sharma. It's Habib Rehman on strike. Again, on the onside, quick single to end that over. And it's a great over by Nihal. Just conceded three runs of that over. Picked up the wicket. And it's 43 for the loss of three wickets. So Shiraz comes to the attack now, right arm round the wicket. The man who hides the ball before bowling, especially for a reason, don't want the batsman to read him very quickly. Habib Rehman, the run machine on strike. Let's see how much he is going to generate today. It's an important game for everyone. Here it is. Full toss ball and the first one hit with a lot of power across the line. The full toss ball being punished towards the wide-ish long on region for boundary. And that is nicely tricked for Habib, far making no mistake, and a wonderful delivery by Shiraz, taking the revenge of that first ball that was hit for a boundary, and he has got his man, sending back Habib to the dugout. That will bring a new batsman in, and I think it will be Manish who will be walking inside, one of the finest leather and tennis cricketer. It's not Manish, but it's Salman who is coming in. Another fantastic player of turf and a tennis ball. He's got a wonderful strike rate. And he's coming there in the center to make some difference here. What they need right now is smashes. They're going on a good score. It's just the sixth over, but these overs are very important because these are the overs where you can hit the maximum runs, but not... Really, it's so easy when you have Shiraz bowling on the other end. Salman with jersey number 9 coming out to the center. Nicely tapped this time, straight in the hands of Preet. Wonderful bowling there by Shiraz. Not giving any room to Sharfu to play that one pretty hard. Now Salman comes on strike. That was in the air. Almost looked like he's checking on that shot. Not quite a confident hit. But a very half-hearted shot just for a single straight in the hands of Bhavik. Standing at the long off region. So Shiraz once again. Again, straight to Nihal this time, only for a single. check, 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 check. All right. So now it's an interesting turnaround here because only two overs are remaining. Kandhari Kings till now have been very, very, very successful in keeping the batsmen's at the lowest. It's 51 only for the loss of four wickets. But as we've seen in the past, the last two overs are the ones who've been always gone in the luck of the batsmen here. So Preet Kumar comes right around the wicket to bowl this one. Sharfu knows that he has to score a lot of runs here because Kandhari Kings yesterday also chased 108. So they've got a good depth in the batting lineup. Trying to hit that one and it will be an easy one. Preet not very cautious, but Yash Babani realized it that he's not got the bails down on the ground. And what a day Preet is having here. I mean, whenever he's in the fielding, the ball is coming on to him. And just when he had a good possibility of the run out, it was thanks to Yash Babani, who was still present. And he realized that the bails are not on the ground. So he had to actually collect the ball once again and jump on the stumps. Reminded me of this wonderful match, South Africa versus Pakistan, where Jonty Rhodes was standing at the point and he had to actually run and throw himself on the stumps to get Inzamam Ul Haq out. It was a wicket in the similar fashion. Sharfu not quite playing the way he generally does. This time he tries to open up a good save there by Sanket. Couple of runs added here. Surely saved two important runs for his team. 53 up for the loss of five wickets. And from here on, it's who delivers. Because as I said, the league stages are over and now we have come to knockouts. That is also a fast one given by the umpire. That is a wonderful strike straight down the ground and that is a beautiful sixer. 59 now. And this is where it gets serious. More nine legitimate deliveries to come at the batsman. Eight deliveries, sorry. And in these eight deliveries, are they going to score the maximum? Because again, Kandhari Kings, as I told you, has got a good depth in the batting. They've been known to score big runs. So Smasher needs a good total to defend. One more. Straight down the ground and two sixes back to back. 65. Well, is he going to get the hat-trick of sixes here? Two amazing shots by Sharfu. Well, this time it's a block hole delivery, much more control line and a very good comeback. What is happening here? It's a no ball and a free hit as well. Straight in the hands of Shiraz, but it won't be any harm for Smashers because it was a free hit. End of seven overs, it is 67 for the loss of five wickets. That is a great, great, great timing. Wonderful timing on that one. That is again a good carpet drive to straight in the hands of the long off fielder for Sharfu. Sanket Rathod almost running back there. That is a great bowling here. 75 up in the air. This time it is Manish, and he brings the maximum. 81 now. More three deliveries to go. How many are they going to score? Are they going to get 100? That is a beautiful shot once again, but straight in the hands of Shiraz. He makes no mistake, and an easy one for Kandari Kings here. Aslam, the new man coming in. So today we have the four big quarterfinals that you're going to be witnessing, and tomorrow the two semifinals and the finals. It's a wonderful scenes out here at the Ather Astro Park, and that's a fast delivery. That is again way outside, but he escapes that somehow. 1 to go. This time it's a clever ball. It's a very clever delivery, and yes, it's a misfield as well. A single converted into two, and what is happening here? They complete the three. A single converted, but only two runs will be counted. Yes, 83 runs on the scoreboard, and it's 84. A long chase for Kandari Kings.
So it's quarterfinals 2, toss time. I've got Mr. Aziz Siddiqui with the coin. Ricky Tigers up against All Stars, all important match coming up. Ricky to call. MCS is the call, and Nihi has won the toss.
Hey, we like to field.
Any specific reasons of fielding?
I think we've been fielding and chasing well, so we'll field.
All right, all the very best. So you guys would have fielded as well?
Yeah, we've been fielding all our games, and unfortunately we've lost this crucial toss, but it'll be nice, we'll be batting first, and let's hope for the best.
All right, all the very best. Thank you. So Ricky Tigers have won the toss, elected to field up against All Stars. All important quarterfinals two coming after this match. So second innings of quarterfinal one coming your way. 84 is the target for Kandhari Kings. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Z. It's a wonderful quarterfinals two also coming up. Ricky Tigers taking on All Stars. Ricky Tigers won the toss, selected to field first, and have invited, of course, All Stars to bat first. But now let's get all focused for the quarterfinals number one, because an exciting score of 83 runs were put up by Smashers, and they're out to field now. But at the same time, it's 84 runs to win for Kandhari Kings. They have done it twice yesterday. Will they do it once again? Yash Bhavani, as you can see him walking, loves to come as the opening batsman. And with him, it is going to be... Nikhil and Yash, the opening pair for Kandhari Kings. Well, a wonderful start here. Yash, don't know why is he hurrying. Aditya Sharma starting the innings for Smashers. Right arm over the wicket. No run again. Why would he want to throw for that? No need. 84 is the chase. The game has started with a lot of excitement here. And that's a clean ball. Look at the celebrations here. Aditya is unstoppable. Minus five. And it was always looking a riskier scene for Kandhari Kings, because Nikhil was not really confidently coming onto the ball. And I think a wonderful piece of bowling by Aditya, trying to move the ball away from the batsman, but sticking to the middle stump and the off stump line and length. And eventually the bales were on the ground, and a clean bowled, bringing in the minus five for Kandhari as well. So minus five up there, and the owner walks in to rescue the situation. Arjun Kandhari, fabulous season that he's had, wonderful striker of the ball, always confident, and comes out with a very positive attitude, simplicity at its best. Here's Arjun Kandhari. White ball to start off with. That is a good strike again, wider to the mid-on region. Rahil coming on the ball. A good ball there once again. It's a wonderful first over to end, and it's still minus three on the scorecard for Kandhari Kings. Bit of a discussion here in the center that who's going to bowl the next over. Is the second over that is coming up. 84 runs to win. Already minus three on the scoreboard. The score hasn't moved in positive figures till now. So Tej coming to bowl this one, but unfortunately, fast bowling is not allowed. So it's a bit of a cliche for Tej, because Tej is not allowed here. You can see Naeem Khan also here, joining the team now. Straight in the hands of Sharfu. Yash Babani, after a long time, gets a strike. He was all-time the spectator at the non-striker's end. Good striker of the ball. Wonderful shot, and he brings in the first cheers in the dugout, of course, with that beautiful sixer, trying to play across the line in the swing of his bat, read the ball very early, and a blasting sixer on the long on region. That is a beautiful number two. There she goes into the fence. Gorgeous one for Yash Babani. He's a promising player, a young lad who's got amazing experience on the turf and been playing some wonderful cricket out here. 10 runs already on the board in a flash just in the second over. Two sixes already to his name. And he's doing fantastic. Well, maybe he's in early to get into semi-finals. White ball. Well, Aslam here trying to tie his luck. But cannot miss the camera eyes of the leg umpire Deepal, and he very calmly says it was a good shout but not really a close one. Wonderful strike. Once again, Yash Babani is only talking here in sixes. Well, maybe not him, but his bat surely is talking only in sixes. Arjun Kandhari has all smiles on his face, and why not? He's truly proud of this young lad, the owner, standing at the non-striker's end, enjoying a movie called Sixers in a Row. This time it's an edge going towards the third man region. Again, a block of line. Arjun wants to go for it. What happened just now? Yes, it's a dead ball. Seventeen up in just the second over. Last ball. Again, a good strike, but this time landing into the declared zone. Only a single here. Yash will still keep the strike or no? It's Arjun Kandari. 18 runs off just two overs. 84 is the chase. And as I told you, they have got a great depth in batting. And that is one of the most crucial things for Kandari Kings and the most important thing in their squad. No, it's Manish who comes to the attack. Manish Shinde coming right around the wicket. In the air, straight in the hands of Salman and Arjun with a soft dismissal here. So Bhavik Joshi now joins Yash Bhavani here, who's been playing excellent at this moment. Straight in the hands of Ankur Takrani. Easy single here. And this is where it makes all the difference. Bhavik Joshi would now continuously keep talking to his batsman. And I think that is what he's done with almost everyone. Led from the front is Bhavik Joshi. A wonderful planner, strategist. And a keen... thinker. He knows that Yash is on fire today and he's going to have a ball of a time in this quarterfinals. He's already got four on his name now. Well. I think he's now applying for the role of being a pilot. He's only taking the aerial route. Is he planning to open his own airlines? Sending each and every ball to this gorgeous fence where you can only give it a sixer. Oh, this is a blinder. This is a blinder. It is a wicket here. What a wonderful catch to this wonderful six machine. Yash Bhavani, truly deserved wonderful catch by Rahul. And now it is the time for a big over, the monster over, brought to you by Bikandari Properties and Nitton. 31 up in just the three overs. So who is the new batsman coming in the center? Is Sanket Rathod. So Habib now comes at the bowling end, very important over for both the teams. Oh, this was nicked. Could have been a good catch behind the stumps. Bhavik trying to find that gap in the covers region. A quick single, Roy coming on the ball, but no chance there. Sanket Rathod was in the crease. Good call. This is again a wonderful delivery, trying to play across the line here. They won't mind that because they have got decent runs on the scoreboard. Nicely tapped again, straight in the hands of the fielder there, and well, no chance there was a run here. Bhavik was a bit early. And there's a bit of a tension here because if this is an out, then it will be a minus five for Kandari Kings. Two amazing fielding chances where they've got the best man out. Yash Babani was playing excellent, was caught at the long off position by Rahul. And now a great piece of fielding, a good throw, and a good presence of mind by Habib Rehman to get Bhavik Joshi out. These are two important, crucial, I would say, the turning points of the match. And somewhere down the line, the scorecard is also being very coincidental here. 33 for the loss of 3 wickets in just 3.4 overs. Well, some time back it was 3-3-3. 28 now for 4 wickets and more 2 to go in this 4th over. Wonderful defense here, because they now know that there is no point of hurrying here, because they've already lost a wicket and they've got a minus five. That's again straight in the hands of Salman there. Shiraz wanted to go for that one, but sent back by Sanket. After the end of 4 overs, it is 28 for the loss of 4 wickets.
Shiraz starts off with a sixer. That is again a clever shot by Shiraz, a very clever one. And he's playing an important knock in the night of the quarterfinals. They'll have to make some serious changes into the field, or else Shiraz will still keep managing to get those gaps. This time it's Sharfu who takes it. 10 quick runs, what a cameo by Shiraz, and wicket falling down. So Far now comes to the center. Fifth wicket is down. It's 38 for the loss of 5 wickets. Good cameo by Shiraz. Sanket still on the non-striker's end. Far coming to the center. Well, there is a fast call by the umpire, but yes, it was nicked and straight in the hands of Manish standing behind the stumps. Quick single here by Sanket. Five runs more to win. This is a good gap. A dive from Aditya will not be able to stop, and two easy runs for Sanket. He's a good chaser. Calculations always on his mind. And he's done that in the past as well for Kandari Kings. So Sanket Rathod standing like a rock in the center. Joined in by Fa, a good supporting role here by Fa. Even he's a hard hitter of the ball, but he waits for the right moment in his batting. Eighteen balls remaining and 43 to win. Here comes Rahil, who's taken a stupendous catch to get Yash Baban out. That one's in the air and in the gap, Habib Rahman. Very good try to catch that one. Throws himself on the ball. And it lands up in the declare zone. So Far will get back to the strike. That is a great strike. What a shot there by Far. I told you. He waits for his right moment to hit those big shots, and he's a wonderful player. A class, and what a timing on that one. Well, just reminded me, my friend IQ here, the way Tony Greig is to commentate for Sachin, especially in the Sharjah. That is a very good delivery, a good comeback, I would say, from Rahul. Oh, this time it's a clever bowling, just keeping outside the off stump and moving the ball away from the batsman. It would have been quite a stretch for Farr to go for it, but he went for a drive, missing the ball completely, straight in the hands of Manish, and he flashes off those bells on time. And a wicket falling down will bring in Dharmesh Panchal to the center. Nicely into the gap, a quick single here, good throw by Aditya, but was wider. 48, last ball of the sixth over. Nicely tapped again, it's a riskier run, and Dharmesh. Well, and I think it was a wrong call because the fielder was standing very close. And one more wicket falling down increases troubles for Kandari Kings here. And that is a good shot, but straight in the hands of Habib Rehman. One more wicket falling down, and Sanket Rathod will return back to the pavilion. Now Nihal comes to the center to make a difference here. Oh, this is a wonderful delivery. Sharfu at its best. It's in the air, and Sharfu, look at the commitment here. What a try. Throwing himself to get that one. But that is the kind of commitment that has made him the player that he is today. The next quarterfinals coming up is Ricky Tigers and All Stars. That's a good strike straight in the hands of Aditya. A directed would have been a bit dangerous. That is again a mistimed shot and a wrong one. One more wicket falling down. And now it comes to the last man for Kandari Kings. What a match. And this one's in the air, and that will go through the B. Kandari Properties board for a Super 8. Is it a Super 8? Is it a 6er or a Super 8? No, it is a 6er. It doesn't touch the board. It is a 6er. Ibja Gold 6er. So Salman now bringing the last over. And it's Faizi on strike. That is a good one. Straight in the hands of Rahil. He's been excellent in that long off position. Just a single. 58 now. One more single. Certainly this singles are not going to rescue the situation that Kandari Kings are in. That is a beautiful strike straight down the ground for a sixer. 65 now. And there it is, the match almost in the hands of smashers. And that's almost a win now for the first quarterfinals. There we're going to see 67, just one delivery left, and it's 84 runs to win. Already a bright smile on the face of smashers. And here it is. Even that sixer will not be able to get them to the semifinals. But yes, the first semifinalist that we have here is smashers.
We would invite Team Smashers near the presentation area, please. Team Smashers near the presentation area, please. So Smashers is the first team to qualify for the semi-finals, which is going to be played tomorrow. So fantastic victory there for Smashers and being the first team to qualify for the semi-finals. I've got Mr. Vicky Gandhari for post-match presentation. We'll start with the man of the match award. There's no guesses. He's got a habit of hitting sixes. He's got a habit of picking